I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Paul left Athens and went to Corinth. There he found Junius, Aquila, and native of Pontus, who had recently come from Italy with his wife Priscilla, because Claudius had ordered all Jews to leave Rome. Paul went to see them, and because he was of the same trade, he stayed with them, and they worked together, By trade, they were tent makers. Every Sabbath, he would argue in synagogue and would try to convince Jews and Greeks. When Silas and Timothy arrived from Macedonia, Paul was occupied with proclaiming the word, testifying to the Jews that the Messiah was Jesus. When they opposed and rebelled him, in protest, he shook the dust from his clothes and said to them, "Your blood be on your heads. I am innocent. From now on, I will go to the Gentiles." Then Paul left the synagogue and went to the house of a man named Titus Justus, a worshiper of God. His house was next door to the synagogue. Crispus, the official of the synagogue, became a believer in the Lord, together with all his household, and many of the Corinthians who heard Paul became believers and were baptized. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. The Lord has revealed the nations his saving power.
The Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power.
O sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous things. His right hand and his holy arm have won him victory. Response.
The Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power.
The Lord has made known his victory. He has revealed his vindication in the sight of the nations. He has remembered his steadfast love and faithfulness to the house of Israel. Response.
The Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power.
All the ends of the earth have seen the victory of our God. Make a joyful noise to the Lord, all the earth. Break forth into joyous song and sing praises. Response.
The Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power.
Alleluia,
alleluia.
The Lord said, "I will not leave you orphans. I will come back to you, and your hearts will rejoice."
Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. When Jesus knew that his hour had come to depart from this world and go to the Father, he said to the disciples, "A little while and you will no longer see me, and again, a little while and you will see me." Then some of the disciples said to one another, What does he mean by saying to us, "A little while and you will no longer see me, and a little while and you will see me, and because I am going to the Father"? They said, "What does he mean by this, a little while? We do not know what he's talking about." Jesus knew that they wanted to ask him, so he said to them, "Are you discussing among yourselves what I meant when I said, 'A little while, and you will no longer see me, and again a little while, and you will see me'? Very truly I tell you, you will weep and mourn, but the world will rejoice. You will have pain, but your pain will turn into joy." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I'm sure we must admit that this is an odd verse from John. He says the same thing three times over. Four times over. First Jesus says it, then the apostles question themselves twice on what he says, and then Jesus reiterates himself. The exact same thing. A little while you'll see me, a little while you won't see me, and a little while you'll see me again. It's like, what is so important about this verse that has to be reiterated four times? Four times. Like, this is a lot of, text in the sacred scripture. This is so important that this has to be reiterated four times. This isn't like a love one another sort of thing, or, thou shalt not kill, one of the commandments. Fascinating. I would encourage you today to spend some time on this verse. Ask what it means to you. It was important enough that John felt it had to be all written out. This four-part, a little while, see me, they won't see me, then they'll see me again. Four times. He writes this out. For some reason. Anyway, so I encourage you to take some time today with that verse, see where it leads you. Dear brothers and sisters, filled with paschal joy, let us pray more earnestly to God that He would graciously listen to the prayers and supplications of His beloved Son. May now be pleased to look upon us in our lowliness. We pray for our Holy Father Francis, for Pope Emeritus Benedict, for our Bishop Joseph, for their health, intentions, and cause of growth in faith, hope, and charity. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the grace to understand your sacred scriptures, to profit from them, to hunger for the time with them each day. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear
us. Pray for those suffering from infectious diseases, especially coronavirus, those who care for them, those who have died. God, may send Joseph to be their guide and patron and their hope in this time of trial. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray that we will not live as orphans today, but live as the true sons and daughters of God. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the grace to reach out to those in need today, especially those who think that God has abandoned them. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In this Mass, we pray in a special way for Mazan Kaufman. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In the moment of silence, we offer for our own prayers and petitions. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all oblates of Mary Immaculate, the priest of the Celebrant Diocese on the feast of St. Eugene de Mazenod. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
we pray for all the holy souls in purgatory. We ask them to join us with all the saints and angels in heaven, especially St. Joseph, our Blessed Mother, St. Eugene de Mazenod, to pray for more vocations to the priesthood, to the consecrated life of the Holy Matrimony, to preserve all those in their vocations and assist us in our universal call of wounds. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
O God, who knows that our life in this present age is subject to suffering and need, hear the desires of those who cry to you and receive the prayers of those who believe in you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we receive the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. You will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we receive the wine we offer you, through the divine work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
May, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice which you have
for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. May our prayers rise up to you, O Lord, together with the sacrificial offerings, so that purified by your graciousness, we may be conformed to the mystery of your mighty love, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up our hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to lodge you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. He never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before you. He is the sacrificial victim who dies no more. The Lamb was slain who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sings together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more
Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for me, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Joseph, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages. We may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, and by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
of the world.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally and come at least spiritually into my heart, I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who restore us to eternal life in the resurrection of Christ, increase in us, we pray, the fruits of this paschal sacrament, and pour into our hearts the strength of this saving fruit, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, your mass is ended.
Ministry to God.
Alleluia, alleluia. Give thanks to the risen Lord. Alleluia, alleluia. Give praise to his name. We have been crucified with Christ. Now we shall live forever. Alleluia, alleluia. Give thanks to the risen Lord. Alleluia, alleluia. Give praise to God has proclaimed his gracious gift, life eternal for all who believe. Alleluia, alleluia. Give thanks to the risen Lord. Alleluia, alleluia. Give praise to him.